Yeah. Uh-huh. You know who it is.
Speedy Tempo, Speedy Tempo, Speedy Tempo.
Hey everyone, my name is Speedy Tempo, and today I'm reacting to Remembrance Episode 3, Heart of Stone by Ashley H. I don't really have anything to say, really, so let's just jump into it. Let's do a recap of what happened last time. Twilight managed to go back in time. She pretty much relived the first two episodes of Season 1 again. And something was wrong. I don't remember what exactly. But we'll probably see that in the... You'll probably see that in the recap for the episode. And then, back in the future, we see Celestia, Luna, and Galaxy meet up with Discord and newcomers, Princess Cadence, who was actually in the thumbnail for this video, and her daughter, Flurryheart, seems to be all grown up. But Cadence seems to be in a some sort of armor for some reason. I guess we'll find out why in exactly 3, 2, 1, and add and go. Previously on Remembrance.
And Galaxy, since Twilight is not here, I want you to guard the elements in her absence.
Galaxy,
we were
the elements.
Around Ponyville looking at the preparations for the Summer Sun Celebration. And
Summer
then
Sun Celebration.
Oh, my Celestia! I did it! I really am back in time!
She went back in time.
What do I do? Maybe it's possible after all.
Oh yeah, the elements disappeared. I forgot about that.
I'm just here to hang out with some old pals. Get back in touch. You know, like the good old days.
Discord, being
oh,
Discord.
It's so wonderful for you to come for a visit, Cadence and Flurryheart.
I have Cadence and Flurryheart looking somewhat determined for something. And you have the intro. Remembrance. Still love that title card thing. Logo.
As we look back on the days of the past and face the future with uncertainty, I promise that
Chippa as Twilight Sparkle. Gina M as Celestia and Chippa as Luna. Otis Cat 123 as Fluttershy and Pinkie Pie.
Time disappears.
Dusk Sparks as Rainbow Dash.
The future is uncertain.
Night of Breath as Applejack. Layla Crazor as Rarity.
On,
Turning Bronies as Discord.
Into the blinding light. The light. The light. The
featuring the Crystal Guards, or the Royal Guards.
Thank you for coming such a long way, you two.
Jeez, Cadence looks so angry.
It's always wonderful seeing some familiar faces.
Likewise. I assume our room is through here.
Of course.
She sounds angry. Or at least
annoyed.
Sorry about my mom. She doesn't really take well to strangers. My name is Flurryheart, by the way. It's nice
there's to
meet
like,
you.
The only stranger here is Galaxy.
Oh, right! Galaxy! Galaxy Star! It's nice to meet you, Princess.
Do you know where Twilight is? I told my mother to keep my arrival a secret so I could jump out and surprise her.
I am very sorry, Flurry. But Twilight has been called out on an important mission, so she won't be back for some time.
Oh, that's okay. I know being the Princess of Friendship must be a full-time job.
Is that Ashley doing Flurry Heart's voice?
Well, I may not be Princess Twilight, but I can show you around if you like. I know this castle like the back of my hoof.
I would love that. Thanks, Galaxy.
My! What's with the long face, Celestia? Are you worried about Cadence?
Yes. I'm not sure if this visit will help her in any way.
It is a tricky situation you put yourself in, but it's not someone I'd get involved in. Toodaloo!
Yeah, too serious for you, Discord. Speaking of serious, I wonder how he reacted when Fluttershy, you know.
Mom, it's me. Please let me in.
Do you want to build a snowmare?
Mom, you should have said something down there, like, hello.
Why? Would that have made any difference?
I don't know. It's just the nice thing to do.
She's straightforward.
Nice thing to do?
Yes. Now, let's open these curtains to get some light in.
Who's voicing Cadence?
I liked it how it was.
All right.
The voice sounds familiar.
Here, let me help you unpack.
What's she looking at?
Mom, maybe this visit is a blessing in disguise.
What do you mean? What are you doing? Don't touch that!
Whoa.
I'm sorry, it's just that...
I told you never to touch this! It's priceless and you know it!
I know, Mom.
Why are we even here? There isn't any events and this is just wasting my time training the newbies.
Training?
Well...
Wait, is she like the new head of the Crystal Guards?
Like Celestia and Luna. They care about you. Dad wouldn't want you to be like this. Everyone wants you to go back to how you were before.
And what does that matter if I talked with them? It's not gonna change anything! This whole visit is a therapy treatment!
Whoa.
Nothing I do matters because he is still gone. Shining is dead, and I have to stay stuck here. I wish Celestia never turned me into an alicorn.
I know you're hurting, but shutting yourself out like this won't change the fact that... that Dad isn't here with us anymore. He would want us to live our life to the fullest and step into the light. Not be stuck in the darkness.
Light? What light? Everything is dull now to when it was before. I have lost the ability to smile. I don't even remember what it was like.
It's not Wubcake.
Happiness.
Is it?
But maybe it's time to finally talk.
Never known Wubcake to voice Cadence before, so I doubt it.
You can talk to me, Mom.
I
care about you. Please, get me into your heart.
It's getting late. You should go to bed.
But Mom!
Please! Just go to bed.
Poor Cadence. I'll always be in your heart, Cadence. That's probably a bad Shining Armor voice.
I walked in your room this morning. I don't know why. I don't know why.
Nice flowing hair. Drawing there.
Our daughter walked by to say hello. I started to cry. I started to cry.
beautiful singing voice. Sorry if I was silent that whole time. Ugh. That was beautiful.
Ow! What just... Why is the book there? What happened?
Shut up.
How is this possible? One minute, I was back when I first met my friends, and now, I don't even know where I am. This spell is useless after all. Ugh.
Pinky, I don't know what that means.
The twitching means my pinky sense is telling me that stuff is gonna fall down. You better check for cover.
What do you mean by...
Ah!
Sorry about that.
Wait, what's going on? Did she, like, skip to
Twilight?
The pinky sense episode?
On your face. I'll run about for you.
That would be lovely.
How did that happen, though?
Spell worked. Why did it send me to here?
So basically, it works like this. I get different little vaguely feelings and they mean different things. Like when my back is itchy, it means it's my lucky day. And when my knee gets pinchy, that means something scary is about to happen.
Uh-huh.
Ooh, my shoulder's achy. You know what that means?
What?
There's an alligator in the
me. Oh, Pinky, I don't have time for these games.
Shouldn't she remember all this?
I have to find the reason why I'm here.
Of course it's time for games. It's always time for games. Here's one. Well, I used to play hopscotch when I was a filly. You go hop, 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 hop. Or you can play jump rope. It's like Cinderella, 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 Cinderella.
How'd she know about Cinderella?
And sometimes, a whole bunch of random things happen in my body at the same time that predict the future. I call them combos.
Mm-hmm. Now, if I trace the trajectory from where I was to where I landed, I can...
Well, I can ear flop, then knee twitch, and eye flutter. That means the sky is about to be graced with a beautiful rainbow.
Yeah, rainbow.
No, I feel a combo coming on. Ear flop, eye flutter, knee twitch. Are you okay, Twilight?
Yeah, just peachy.
Yeah, good. You know, Twilight, you've had your head in that book all day.
Yes, well, this is really important.
You know what you
nice need, call Twilight. Out, Mr. Rito Queen.
Hey, I need that back.
Aw, come on, Twilight, have a little fun.
I don't need fun. I need my book back.
I got a feeling that you could
another song
be
already.
If you just take
and
a look
somewhat animation.
At me. When I get stressed out, I wanna pull my hair out. There's one thing that always sets me free. When life pushes you down and you can't get back up, just put those thoughts away. I'll land always say,
it's just...
Come on, Twilight, it's easy. If you only try to turn that frown upside down. Life gets you down, and you don't know why. Just pick your hooves up and skip away. Take a break.
What?
Sit down and relax. There is no need to be ashamed. Take a break.
Pinky, please. I don't need a break. I need to focus.
I can be quiet. Take a break. Come on, Twilight, it's easy. If you only try, every pony.
Isn't there a Hamilton song called Take a Break, too?
Turn the frown upside down when you start to feel.
I'm gonna guess that this is like a parody of that.
There's one thing you need to do.
Pinky! No! I've had enough!
Whoa.
I'm going back to the treehouse.
Does she mean library?
Twilight? Are you okay?
Yeah, Spike. It's just I've been looking at this book for the entire day, and I don't know what I'm supposed to be doing here.
Didn't Princess
try looking at the red books, or the blue books, or the white books?
Friendship?
Yeah,
they're
but...
all in the background over there.
Never mind. You're right.
I know I am. Now, I'm going to go for a walk.
Star Swirl, what were you doing? It says that the spells send you back for a short time, but nothing else. I haven't been sent back, which means I haven't restored the elements. But how in the hey am I gonna do that? Ugh! Why are you so cryptic?
Does it say Queen is Queen? On that bookshelf over there.
Did you forget something again, Spike? Ugh! Pinky, what do you want? I'm very busy.
I know that, Twilight, and I wanted to say that I'm really sorry for taking your book back there. I know that it was probably really important to you.
Well, thank you, Pinky. Apology accepted.
Yeah, thank you, Twilight! Now I just discovered a new candy recipe. You want to go taste it with me and Applejack? Whoa!
Pinky, are you all right?
I just had a doozy. It's gonna happen in Froggy Bottom Bog! We have to go there!
Oh, okay, Dorito Queen fun. Is best queen. That's
but
what it
Twilight.
Says.
That's where Fluttershy went not too long ago.
I'm sure she's just fine.
I don't know about that, Twi.
Don't you remember the,
she could be
eating Hydra?
Her mom to a pit and die, her turning to ice creamer.
Ugh. If I go with you, will you leave me alone after?
Yep.
Fine.
So, what do you think happened?
Oh, this is, Trues art.
Nothing.
Yeah.
I know, but what do you think happened? I'm trying not to think about it. Me too. But I'm thinking about it anyway. Like, what if she exploded? Just exploded? For no reason? Yeah, like boom!
Whoa! What if she exploded and then exploded again?
Can you explode twice?
Of course not.
But what if she exploded and exploded again and then...
I'm sure she's perfectly fine and we are just wasting time.
I hope you're right. For Fluttershy's sake. Look! There's Froggy Bottom Bog! Fluttershy! Fluttershy!
Where are you? Yes?
Fluttershy! You're okay!
Of course. Ah, I'm so glad you're okay!
See, like I said, everything is okay. Meaning that this little journey was pointless, and I could have been figuring out what I'm doing here.
What's with that face?
No, AJ. This has been happening all day long, and all I want to do is read my book in peace. But you ponies keep dragging me away from where I should be. I'm sorry I scared you, but I just needed to tell you.
Twilight, we aren't scared of you. Don't turn around.
Oh, right.
Now you remember.
Run!
Over here! Everyone, up that hill!
Help!
I got you, Spike. Hang on!
Isn't there a spell that can turn the Hydra into a mouse?
No. But I do know something else. There. He won't be bothering anyone again.
Whoa! Twilight, that was amazing!
Yeah, it was. I haven't done something like that in a long time.
Hey, this is kind of a change.
Twilight?
Oh, Pinky.
Hello. Are you okay?
Do you need some help, Twilight?
It's just... I haven't laughed that hard in a while. Your hair!
I guess it is pretty funny.
Oh, Twilight, didn't you go back to reading that important book of yours?
I think the book can wait. Didn't you say you wanted to show me that new candy recipe?
Oh, what the, huh?
Pinky, your cutie mark!
Yeah, it's pretty fun, right?
No,
what?
It's glowing.
No, it isn't, silly.
That's not supposed to happen for like 5 seasons. What?
Whoa.
What just happened?
This place is so beautiful. Thank you for showing me around, Galaxy.
No problem, Princess. This place has always been like home to me.
You can just call me Flurry, since we're friends now.
Friends?
Of course. Now, have we searched every part of the castle already, or are there any more secret tunnels for us to explore?
Well, there is one place. Watch your step!
Where are you taking me, Galaxy?
You'll see.
Whoa. This place is amazing.
I go here whenever I have to practice my magic, since it can be a little unpredictable.
What is that like? Being the protege of the Princess of Friendship. Do you get to go on dangerous quests?
Sometimes I remember one time we went to Manhattan for a fashion show, and I got completely lost. It took 4 whole hours for Princess Twilight to find me.
Wow, that sounds amazing.
Did you get called up on the PA system?
I wish I could do stuff like that.
What do you mean?
Like,
you're the Princess of the Crystal Empire. I'm sure you go on tons of amazing...
Attention, Princess Twilight, we have your protégé at the front desk. Please come to the front desk to pick her up. Thank
my
you.
My family and I used to go on hundreds of journeys, but ever since my dad died, my mom, she never lets me go anywhere. Like, she's too afraid to keep me out of her sight.
But you're here now.
Yes, but that's only because I begged her to bring me along. I'm sick of looking at the same old crystal walls every day, but my mom, she changed after Dad died. She closed herself off from all emotions and took over his position as captain of the Royal Guards. It hit her hard. Mm. So, she decided to keep me as close as possible. But it's okay. I mean, I'm here now. The stars are truly beautiful. I wish I was Princess Twilight's student.
Yeah, well, I'm sure you would probably do a better job at it than I am.
What do you mean?
Every pony hates me! Think I'm a joke because I can't do anything right! When Princess Twilight was a unicorn, she could do anything! She was Princess Celestia's prize pupil and saved Equestria! And I can't even teleport more than 6 feet.
That's not true. You're the kindest pony I've ever met, and I'm sure Princess Twilight chose you as her pupil for a reason.
I guess.
Another song?
You know why I come up here? Because
another song?
Every time I feel on a snow, I look up at the sky. I think that I am so small compared to every pony else. I just want to be useful to some pony for once in my life. And not have them look at me with pity.
Yeah, that feels.
I try and I try.
Yep, another song.
The puzzle they want, but to everyone around me, I'm invisible. There are two, maybe three ponies that believe in me, but to the others, I won't fit the mold. No matter what I do. Every day is like the other. Disappointment is around the bend. I'm alone in the universe. So alone in the universe. No pony understands what I'm facing. They all call me a disgrace. Okay, call me a disgrace. Any replacement would have been better. 'Cause I'm alone and I can't fly around.
Well, you're not a Pegasus.
Beyond the sky, but someday soon, I know I will find my small place in the universe, one true friend in the universe, who believes in me.
I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe.
Nice wingspan.
I don't even know what love is.
Alone in the universe.
Shut out, kept under lock and key. My mother turned away from me. I just want to heal her.
Why does her arm look like a motherboard?
But I'm a
motherboard. Ironic.
I can't fly.
I can't fly.
Wait, you should be able to fly.
One true friend in the universe
who believes in me.
Oh, Galaxy,
I'm sorry for stealing your song.
It's okay. It's something I've always had to live with. I know the princesses believe in me, but
They don't understand the pressure I'm under. I haven't found anyone who knows what it's like.
I understand. You don't want to do the wrong thing and then have them pull away from you suddenly.
Exactly.
Well, I can tell you one thing, Galaxy. You're not alone anymore. Wanna know why?
Why?
Because you have me.
You have me.
Called it.
You're not alone. And you can fly.
I still can't fly, though. Unless she grabs onto you.
Always be here, you can count on me. To be that one voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Who believes in me.
What are you doing?
It's called a hug.
Everything better.
What's that? It's the chest with the elements of harmony the princess has told me to guard. I brought it up here because this is where I usually sleep. But why is
it you usually sleep on the balcony?
What does that mean?
It means she's doing it. Princess Twilight is bringing back the elements!
Look at all the cold-hearted... Look at the cold-hearted mare. Look at the ponies so full of care, but soon they will be aware that... They finish reading that. Ugh. Well, that was an interesting episode. Whew. You got the artists. I guess Hidity did all the animation stuff at the end there. Okay, with you, sung by Broadway Juliet, Kane's singing song, singing voice, animated by Amy Chan. Take a break. Oh, turn it off from the Book of Mormon. That's what it was. Okay. Alone in the Universe, Alex Wells. Alone in the Universe from Suicide Squad musical. I think it was like Steven Universe, but I don't remember anything like any song like that being sung in there. So, that makes sense. Bernie Cooper, art director, Silver Thrill, script editor, creative director, Cadence VA, Dual Harmony Gamer. Kane is singing, Broadway Juliet, Galaxy singing, Silver Swirls, Flurry Heart, FTH, Kate Bug is Spike, and Tommy Taco is Derby. I mean, yeah, I said that right. Is that it? I guess so. Alright, I guess I'll start my remarks here. Yeah, this was an interesting episode. It definitely answered my question as to why Cadence had that angry face. I mean, it makes sense that she would feel bitter about losing shining armor like that. I like the songs, especially with you. It definitely struck a chord with me. As you can probably tell from my reaction to it. Oh man. Feels. Man, Ashley wasn't kidding. Neither was Sky. I remember when this episode first came out, Sky was singing that song repeatedly, and I can see why. Definitely. Oh man, definitely got to me, too. Oh jeez. Whew. Now, Twilight went back in time, and now she went forward in time a bit from where she was. because the elements disappeared, and then she suddenly jumped to the Pinky Sense episode. I forgot what Feeling Pinky Keen, I think it was called. And, I don't know how it happened, but Twilight was able to resurrect the element of laughter, I guess by laughing at Pinky when she fell in the mud, which was kind of awkward, to be fair. I mean, she was laughing like Celestia did to her in the season 7 opener. If you haven't seen that yet, I'm sorry for the spoiler. But, yeah, that was interesting. So I'm guessing that she's going to keep jumping forward in time, possibly even going backwards and forwards, to different episodes that focus on different elements. So I wonder which episode she's going to go to next, and which element is going to be resurrected. That's interesting to think about. Guess we'll see in the next episode. And the art, it was amazing, as usual. I also liked how they implemented some animation into some of the musical numbers. That's definitely an eye-catcher for me. You don't really see that much in many of the audio dramas. So, it's definitely a sight to see once it's done. Okay, I guess that's all I have to say about this episode. Can't wait to see what happens in episode 4. I know that there's going to be a certain song sung by a certain someone that I know in it. So I can't wait to see that. But for now, my name is Speedy Tempo, and I'm out. See you guys.